the investigative journalist, the author of multiple books, his most recent, How Trump Stole 2020. GregPalast.com is his website. Greg_Palast is his Twitter handle. And Greg, I should have known that at some point you were you had something to do with her. You were investigating what was going on with the power down in Louisiana. We've got a million or more people now who have no electricity, and it seems to me like this might be a replay of the California thing, where you've got a for-profit utility that, instead of expensively burying cables where they wouldn't start wildfires or get blown over by a hurricane, they left them above ground because it was cheap, and they could then shovel that money that they charge ratepayers into their own pockets. So, do I have that right in the thumbnail?
You've got it right in the thumbnail. In fact, it was, you might as well say that George Bush had his hand on the switch and turned off. George W. Bush, with his deregulation of electricity, turned off the lights in Louisiana and Mississippi. In 1986, before I was an investigative reporter, I had a real job. I was an investigator, and I was hired by the city of New Orleans to find out why their renegade power company named Entergy, its division called New Orleans Public Service, but it's a big part of a giant company called Entergy, why the lights kept going on. This is before Katrina. This is before any of this. Why the lights kept going off and the rates were flying through the roof. And what I concluded for the government was that this company, Entergy, was a racketeering enterprise parading as an electricity company. They were siphoning off hundreds of millions of dollars. The state adopted my position, or the city, that they fined the company over $100 million.
I mean, this is what Enron was doing back around the same time, right? This was the 80s.
Oh,
this was the Reagan era.
But, I told them, I said, look, there's only one solution, and the people of the city in a referendum voted for it. The solution is socialism. Get rid of this private company, these privateers who've got you by the bulbs, and to make it a public system. The public voted for it, and then, they used, their good Citizens United funding to make sure that that the city of New Orleans never went through with the purchase. Well, then what happened is Katrina. And this big power company, Entergy, instead of fixing the system of New Orleans, left the city in the dark for a year because they decided to put their little company of New Orleans, a segment that serves New Orleans, into bankruptcy court. You'll love this. While the parent company was claiming record profits, citing, quote, weather conditions, the weather being Katrina. So they bankrupted their New Orleans company, said, we're not responsible for fixing the system or the damage we did, but our parent company, hey, we're going to pocket the money from the extra charges from the electricity that we charge a bundle for during Katrina.
Yeah.
And then since then, Entergy, same thing. Their parent company has been siphoning off the funds that were supposed to go to hardening this system. I got to tell you, Tom, 2,000 miles of high voltage cable have gone down. 2,000 miles. I mean, I literally have worked in Pakistan, a place like that. You don't see in Bangladesh 2,000 miles of high voltage line go down in a typhoon. But again, in Louisiana, they aren't victims of Hurricane Ida. They are victims of Entergy, this power company, this renegade power company, which overcharges their subsidiaries and has been, under the guise of deregulation and other trickery, has been basically tiptoeing off with the money meant to keep the lights on. That's what we pay them for. It's a monopoly still, no matter what you call it. And that's what they do.
Yeah, it's like PG&E in California. And when Enron was dissolving, I was around that time, actually I think it was a year or so after that, I was doing a local show here. I was doing my national show from Portland, but I was also doing a morning show. And we had on the mayor, and we had on, for Portland. And Portland was trying to buy the electric company, this city. And they had the money. The company was up for sale. It had to be spun off from Enron because Enron was going to prison or getting dissolved or whatever. And it was
going to prison.
Yeah, it was X dollars. It was like $1.1 billion or something like that. And the city said, "Fine, we will give you your asking price." And they said, no, we will not sell to a nonprofit. We will not sell to a city. This has to remain in the hands of stockholders who can bleed it dry and screw the rate holders. And so we are still dealing with for-profit companies, power companies here in the Pacific Northwest, because they literally refuse to sell to the city. Is there any recourse for the citizens of Louisiana, more generally in New Orleans specifically, to get out from under the thumb of a for-profit parasite like this?
Well, I hope that they will once again consider what was done in New York, taking over a bad system. In California, the city of San Francisco and San Jose said, we'll buy out the PG&E system here, which is, the Arsons R Us company. So public power has been producing energy safely, reliably, in about one-third less than the privateers. But I did find out what happened in Portland with my sources within the banking community, which said, look, if this company goes private, the banks that are funding this operation, they'll get hosed. And that's what they're worried about. Behind it are the banks, which make billions off this game. And including, and by the way, let's not forget the role of one of the reasons, and I always find that when I'm dealing with kind of criminal enterprises, the racketeering work I've done for the Justice Department, it's not just greed. They're usually motivated by panic because they made a wrong investment. And in the case of Entergy, they became a big nuclear power operator, and they had a plant called Grand Gulf in Mississippi, or Grand Gulf as it was officially called. And they're pouring money down this nuclear hole. And after nearly bankrupting themselves with that, and then trying to steal the money from the repairs on the power line, they doubled down. They bought Indian Point Nuclear Plant in New York. That was brilliant. They were buying nuclear plants all over the country. So you have George Bush and his deregulation. You have going down the nuclear financial rat hole. And, of course, just plain old greed and shenanigans of privateers who say, oh, we have a market. Well, I don't know. I got one light switch on each wall, not seven to choose from. It's still a monopoly. And right. This is what government regulation is supposed to do, protect us from privateers. Let's not forget that. That regulation is actually democracy in action in the economy.
Amen. That's why governments are instituted among men, to quote the Constitution, not to be sexist here, but you get it. Anyhow, Greg Palast, gregpalast.com, the website, Greg_Palast on Twitter. You're the best, Greg. Thanks a lot for dropping by. Thanks for the information.
You're very welcome.